Today, I want to talk about three very common misconceptions about space travel.
Myth number one, space is really far away. Many people imagine that the Earth looks like this. Above the Earth, you have a thick layer of air and then space. But this image is wildly inaccurate. In reality, this layer of air is thin compared to the size of the Earth. Where exactly does space begin? This is a difficult question to answer because there's no clear boundary, but a popular choice is to say that space begins at the Kármán line, 62 miles up. This is not far away. Think of it this way. The distance from LA to San Diego is larger than the distance from LA to space. Myth number two. The hard part about space travel is getting into space.
Behind me, I have a rocket ship with just enough fuel to get us into space. Let's go.
All systems are go.
I'm going to space. I'm going to space. I'm going to space.
Ignition and liftoff.
I'm in space. I'm in space.
Whoa, what's happening? I'm falling. I'm falling.
The hard part about space travel isn't getting into space. The hard part is getting enough speed that you don't immediately fall down. The space station is 250 miles up. It would immediately fall down if it wasn't traveling at 17,000 miles per hour. It requires 360 million joules of energy to lift a person to that height. But to get to that speed, you need more than 7 times that amount of energy. At that speed, you could travel almost half the United States in the time you watch this video. Myth number three, astronauts float in space because they have escaped Earth's gravity. The force of gravity is weaker on the space station because it's further away from the center of the Earth. But it's not that much weaker because it's not that far away. The force of gravity is only 10% weaker on the space station. The reason that astronauts float is because they're in free fall. Imagine being shot out of a cannon. You're essentially weightless the entire time you're falling down. Now imagine being fired out of a cannon at 17,000 miles per hour. You would be going so fast that you would never hit the ground. This is what happens on the space station. Gravity's still there, but the station is moving so fast that it never hits the ground. For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe.